Reading right there. know it's not right, you may be seated in the presence of the living God. I know I did not finish it all, because we already ministered the word of God. But I came underneath the auspices of the Holy Spirit to let you know, and you know, God is. I looked at this text, and the text is so pregnant with possibility. The first two words he said in this verse was, God is. I want you to let that marinate right there. God is. He said, God is. Understand that that's all you need. In fact, that's all it is. God is. If I could give you some Elder King theology, my grandfather told me that it's a blank check that's already been endorsed. So what you have to do is just fill in the blanks of what God is. I wish somebody said, in anything you need, God is. I just need two and I'll make three. If you understand the pregnancy of this two words, God is, there is no explanation, no need to talk, no need to fuss and bust. It just says God is. And I want you to understand, you have to stand on the promises basis on God is. First of all, you see that the base of the text says God is. I'm going to give you three points, and I think the Spirit of the living God has already moved in this place. We understand that God is a covering. I wish somebody understood that God is a covering. See, you may know me, but you don't know a lot of things about me. But the thing I love about God is he is a covering. He covers me when I'm weak. He covers me when I'm worn. He covers me. See, when folks lie on me and talk about me, the good thing is that they don't know everything. But God is. He is a covering. He is a covering. I came to give somebody some good news that God is a covering. See, he covered you. He covered you from that divorce. He covered you. He covered you from being a drug addict. He covered you. He covered you from being a thot. He covered you. He covered you from being a crackhead. He covered you. He covered you from being an adulterer. He covered you. It's nothing like the covering grace of God. God is the present tense. God is. He is. He is our strength and he's our refuge and our strength. That's why our haters can't take me out, because I'm in the refuge. Somebody ought to understand. If we understand the godness, the isness of God, God is. Somebody say God is. God is a capable covering. God is. God is. Not only that, he is a capable covering. God is a companion. Oh, yeah. He's a companion. See, if you had any people that are around you and they say that you are a ride or die, I have two nieces, Siesta and Mookie, and I can call them anytime that I want. You know, with names like that, you know, these girls can fight. You know, when somebody says Siesta and Mookie, you call them, they on their way. So I have those ride or die in my life, and this mic is about to work me over. But I want to let somebody understand that in the midst of is a ride or die. He steps in. He steps in just when you need him the most. He steps in just when you need him every hour, every step, every minute of the day. He is a companion. See, the situations that come up when we're looking for companions, we look for flags. There's flags when you look for companions. And sometimes when you have those things, they show their signs. See, you can't look for a companion because there's a flag. See, you try to deal with somebody, but there's a... See, I wish somebody would understand what I'm saying. You know you can't depend on nobody else but God, so he is. He is a companion. I remember when I was in school and they had a thing way before Facebook and way before Twitter and Twitter and stuff. This was in the MySpace in Black Panic. You don't know about that. About that time. And they used to bring, around that time, they used to bring it in a classroom, the TV. And the TV was connected to a, you know, one of those things you pull in, and then if you had the right really nice school, the TV was up there, and it was called, I think it was called Channel 1 or something like that. And they would do that. And there was an interesting thing that I remembered about this Channel 1. And Colin Powell, late Colin Powell, told the story about, told the story. And the question was given to the late Colin Powell. And it was said, the question was asked to Colin was, who is the president that you will remember the most? And he said, Ronald Reagan. And they asked the question, why would you say Ronald Reagan? And Colin said, because I'm endeared to him. And he says, I'm endeared to him. And he said something while I did something. Colin was saying that I did something in the midst of me serving. And the president said, I did it. I wish I could see what I'm saying. See, the President Reagan said, I made a mistake. And when it hit the press, the president took the fall. And Colin said, it was my fault. But the president took the fall. Reagan said, I did it, and I want to apologize that I did it. Colin stood there in the corner with tears in his eyes and told one of his assistants, I'll die for that man. And they said, why would you die for that man? Because he said, instead of him crucifying me, he saved me. I wish somebody would come closer and understand. That's why I love God, and that's why you know limited information about me. Because when you could crucify me, he covered me. He's that kind of companion that he'll cover you. Just when you need everything to be all right, he's there to cover you. He is that kind of companion that you need. He is that security that you need. He's that one that when you're in the midnight hour, you ain't got to worry about who's bumping around, and you ain't got to see, are you going to go down and look for it? Are you going to go down and hear it? No. I've got some security because he's my companion. See, I remember Linus, and Linus was the Lord that had the blanket, and everywhere Linus went, he had the blanket, and with the blanket, pass me the blanket, and when he had the blanket, everywhere Linus went, he had his blanket with him because he needed security. He needed some security. But thanks be to God, what God does, he takes that is securing me and turns around and covers me. He covers me so you don't see me. Even though you see me, you don't see me. You don't see the issues that are inside of me. Thank you, Lord, for covering me. You can just call me Linus. Because I've got a covering. Do I have a covering? But I understand that in this third point, and we're going home in a moment. In this third point, we find that he is a competent creator. Let me say that again. He is a competent creator. See, that's why it's so important to me that you have to understand, when life's hell and life has its ups and downs, and sometimes you're in and out of situations, but thanks be to God, no matter what the situation is, I came to tell you the truth that he'll never leave you or never forsake you. When you're praying and when you're fasting, he's still there to cover you. Can I get somebody to help me? Or maybe you need some Bible, because the Bible says in Psalms 41:11, now I know thou favor is on me, because thou enemies have not taken away from me. In other words, I'm not waiting for him. He's waiting on me. And he's right by my side to lead and to guide me, to hold me when my only that I'm still here, that I'm happy that I'm here because he is my covering. Somebody just say, God is my covering. God is my companion. God is my confidence creator. So when I feel low in my spirit, I know I can go to somebody and he'll lead me and he'll guide me and he'll hold me and he'll keep me from all harm and danger. I'm done. There is